If you look good, you feel good, and if you feel good, you perform good. Like, you guys ever heard of that one before? I don't know. Let's get into it. Maybe I'm just that materialistic. What is going on, you guys? Nick from Freakout Fitness. It is relatively early for me this morning. It's Saturday morning. Normally, I sleep in. But I'm excited to go and crush at the gym today. Day 3 on the new program, Big Beyond Belief. So we're going to go and do chest, back, biceps, and calves, I believe. But I want to show you guys something real quick. If you guys follow me on Instagram, you probably have already seen it. But I want to show you guys something. I need a new pair of shoes. I mean, my shoes that I have now are just tore all the way up. Bam. Love these things. Look how clean these things look. I've been wanting a new pair of shoes just to wear around. You know, maybe wear to the gym. I think I want to get a pair of the Reebok CrossFits for the gym. I've heard a lot of good things about them. But I got these Kobe's for like $50 at Olympia last night. So it was too good of a deal to pass up. You guys have probably already seen. I've been wearing these Reeboks. I've had these for like a year. These things are super comfortable. But there, if you can see the bottom, I don't know if you can see the bottom of these, but there is literally no tread, like, left on the bottom of these. I almost broke my neck one day trying to go to work wearing these. It was pretty ridiculous. And then I have another pair here. I've had these ones for even longer, more than a year. I'd say probably 2 years. And they've got, like, holes going on. Here, let's see if we can get it. Like, holes going on here in the back of them again. Like, see if you can see the heels here. Like, no tread on the heels. So I needed a new pair of shoes. I've been, you know, trying to put it off. But finally, you know, I said, it's something that needs to get done. So I got a new pair of shoes. Buddy Brennan, the one who I did shoulders with in one of my last videos, he always picks on me for wearing this hoodie, and I think I've had this thing, like, it's funny, this hoodie actually has quite a story behind it, because my aunt bought it for me for Christmas. This is back when I was, you know, at my heaviest, and I couldn't fit into it. You know, I was just too big, and it was too small. But I kept it, and I don't really know why I kept this hoodie, but I kept it with the tags and everything hung up in my closet. And once I started to lose the weight, I kind of forgot about it, and I was cleaning out the closet one day, and here was this hoodie with the tags on it and everything. It's almost like it was meant to be, you know, like I was meant to keep this hoodie, you know, and wear it now. But I've had this thing for a couple years, ever since I started losing weight. But I kid with Brennan and tell him, you know, this is like for nostalgia, you know, this is like my good luck charm, my hoodie, man. I love this hoodie. Shout out to you, Aunt Kate, for getting me this hoodie. Also, too, one other thing, I've been meaning to do this for a while now, and I haven't. It just doesn't cross my mind when I'm at the store to pick one up, but I finally picked up a binder. I threw my Arnold Amateur sticker on there. But I just wanted a little notebook to keep up with my... to log, like, all my exercises and all my strength, make sure that I'm progressing in the gym. You know, a lot of the times people can go to the gym and just lift weights and, you know, not really progress. But one thing I notice is a lot of lifters that really focus on strength and progression use notebooks. So that's something I'm going to try to get more involved with. And I'm going to start doing it today, logging it. I even think I'm going to even log, like, my weight along side of it. I weighed in, like, 158 today, so... gonna put that in my notebook. Got the new kicks on. I know I've been talking a lot about these shoes, but it's kind of funny because, like, a lot of the times when I go and buy shoes, like, I'm the type of person that buys shoes that are, like, you know, on clearance or, you know, $40 or under or something like that, you know. But I've never really owned, you know, like a nice pair of basketball shoes before. You know how people, like, you know, that are sneakerheads, you know, oh, they have all of the Jordans, you know, or, you know, they can remember the first time they got a pair of Jordans. Well, I don't think I've ever owned... No, I think one time I did, I owned, like, a pair of Jordans, but they weren't, like, basketball Jordans. They were, like, cross-trainer Jordans. But I'm just excited about getting a new pair of shoes. I don't know if... It's almost like one of those things where it's, like, if you look good, you feel good, and if you feel good, you perform good. Like, you guys ever heard of that one before? I don't know. Let's get into it. Maybe I'm just that materialistic. Freaking wireless earbuds died, so now I got this... you know, 10-foot cord of headphones going on here, but going today's rep range could be 10 to 12, so let's get it, let's go.
Your reflection in my wine glass, that's when I look away, can't stand and think about losing your fine ass. How do I let you slip away, life for the party, but I'm dead inside, kill my vibes, it was genocide, hard to act like I've been alive. I'm trying to find where I identify. One time for the girl that got away. Two times for the bub I'm about to spray. Three times for the power that I pray to. Are you up there? Can you hear me? I know I fucked up. It's clear, see. I'm 22, but I don't act like it clearly. And all this shit is a mirage. I'm just rapping for a cause. The life, the fame, the life's the game. We break the laws, don't like to change. Wanna win you back, but I hate to lose. I know that you're the one, but it's hard to choose. In my red cup. Remember first day you wouldn't give it up. We had only scratched the surface, but I knew that you were worth it. Yeah, yeah. So I was patient. I bragged to my niggas, your name it. I'm still with the niggas that I came with. But everything changed once some fame hit. Make it up, take you down. Have a shot, I'm out around. Play my songs, you like the sound. It's going down, it's going down. Let's drink coffee, watch passerbys, and prove to you I'm not the average guy. It's just my flaws that they magnify, and when it's real, you don't have to try. Sometimes I wanna run away.
There we have it, guys. That is day three of Big Beyond Belief. Day three of ramp one. Still only three sets for each exercise, but we're doing 10 to 12 sets. And then tomorrow will be the next day, do 10 to 12, but it'll be legs, and then I think it switches to 8 to 10. So you start with higher amount of reps, and then slowly the week goes down, you lower the reps, and then next week you'll do more sets. Check out the program if you want to, but felt really good. Hopefully off of this program, I'll be able to increase my strength, but also the size of my muscles, the hypertrophy. So quick video of the day, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. This program is going to be relatively a lot of the same stuff, but you basically work yourself up towards overtraining, and then you dip back down into the optimal training zone, almost to undertraining, and then back up. That's how this program is supposed to work. But thanks for watching today's video, guys. I know it was relatively short, not much really going on. Hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and as always, have an awesome day.